Every phenomenon we know is part of a so-called system. Cattle is part of a farming system. Houses are part of a system we call a city. And these farms and cities are part of a system called planet Earth. In systems analysis, we translate such situations into a conceptual description. This might sound like we are going from a concrete situation to an imaginary theory. However, the contrary is true. System descriptions help to identify all the relevant elements in your situation. And by visualizing them, you can unravel the connections between them. In this clip, I will explain how to describe such a system. A system is defined as a set of interrelated elements. These elements are structured and continuously influence each other. From my earlier example, the houses are elements in the system of a city. Let me first tell you the five types of system elements that are essential to recognize and include in a system description. These are the components, the interactions between components, the system boundaries, the inputs, and the outputs. I will now discuss each of these elements using this MOOC module as example. The components are the first elements to consider. In a MOOC module, the components are the module subsections, the developers, like myself, participants like yourself, and the software interface. You can envision these subsections or components as black boxes. In this case, you do not include any information on the internal features, content or operation. When you perform a sustainability analysis, you can actually include mechanistic models that describe the relation between components, the environment and the performance of your component of study. For now, we will consider the components as black boxes. You already experienced an interrelation between the subsections. For example, the exercises are linked to the clips. Furthermore, the modules have been included in the software interface, and at the moment, you as a participant are connected to the module content. You are actively providing input to the system as a participant. You do this by viewing the clips in a certain order and entering answers to the assignments. The output of the MOOC is the result of the exercises, case study, and exam. I could, of course, take a closer look into the structure and content of a MOOC instead of only the modules. In that case, the module turns into a subsection of the MOOC. At the beginning, I stated that we are going to take a look at the MOOC module as an example of a system. In doing so, I've chosen the system boundaries of my system. I include all the components of a module, but I do not consider the other modules in the MOOC. It often helps to visualize the system as a diagram. You can see a so-called relational diagram on this sheet. The diagram helps to simplify the essential components and their relations. Such a diagram, you can distinguish the different components using blocks. Arrows can be drawn to indicate the relations between the components. A typical example is a flow diagram used in process engineering, or a material flow diagram for environmental engineering. The system boundaries are commonly indicated by a dashed line. Your inputs and outputs will pass this line. Let's take a closer look at the system boundaries. The boundaries describe the limits of your system, so they indicate what is included and what is not. Which system boundary is appropriate depends on the question you want to answer. First, consider the technical scope of your boundaries. The technical scope contains all the physical and technical components in your system. This includes, for example, unit operations, manufacturing chains, and factories. It is important to also consider the relevant scale of operation, as it determines which data you need. This brings me to the second scope, the geographical or spatial scope. Is your bio-based chain based on a regional processing, or do you want to analyze all inputs and outputs for a globally central processing plant? You can surely imagine that the location of your bio-based process can can influence the sustainability impact. For example, ethanol can be produced by a variety of feedstocks. In Brazil, ethanol is produced from sugarcane, but in the US from maize. This does influence the components in your system, and it will also influence which data is relevant to your sustainability analysis. Besides the technical and spatial scope, you also need to consider the time scope. Is the aim of your study to analyze the change in performance over time, or will you perform a study based on historical data? Or are you going to make a projection of the future? Under all these scopes, technical, spatial, and time, the system is embedded on our planet. This is considered the natural system scope. To summarize, in this clip, I have explained how to describe a system. The five essential elements that you need to include are the components and the interaction between the components, the inputs, outputs, and finally the system boundaries. For the system boundaries, you should consider the technical, spatial, and time scope.